our courts have entertained, that is, received cases that are filed, 1,500 at a time, against individuals. And I was assigned in the district court, the trial court, which is what I do. I am a trial judge. I had to coordinate this and make some sense of it so there weren't many conflicting rulings. Who was being sued in these cases? Students, mostly college students, some high school students, sometimes their parents, sometimes individual adults. Who was suing them? The big music companies, RCA, you name it. When you buy a CD, look on the back, or a DVD, look on the back and you can see the names of the music companies that own the rights to music when it is produced and marketed for the mass public. Well, what was happening was, by use of computers and the internet, the songs, individual songs, were being downloaded to be enjoyed and then uploaded and shared. They call that peer-to-peer file sharing. I had to learn that because I can't do it myself. and I found out a lot about internet, computers, and this mechanism called a server, which would allow this to happen. Now, what's wrong with that? Isn't anything on the internet free? Well, you might think so. That was one argument that we heard in defense of the students. And I'm only sharing it with my sister or my college roommate. And why were so many cases filed right here in Philadelphia? Because we have a conglomeration of colleges with dormitories, and this was chosen, selected as a venue by the music companies, most of which were in New York and California. So I had to make some sense of this, and many of the students did end up having a small settlement, much smaller than if they went to trial. These cases went to trial in some federal district courts in the Midwest and in New England. And when the person who illegally and violated the copyright were found to be liable, this is a civil case, not a criminal, so they weren't convicted of a crime. When they were found to be liable, they were then assessed damages. And the copyright law allows as much as $7,500 per song. Wow. If you were doing this on a weekend and you shared with 30 people, you can do that math. And that is a $280,000 verdict in one case, $250,000 in another. And you know, verdicts don't have anything to do with your ability to pay it. So it was a real situation. Most of those cases were resolved short of trial. A lot of them were dismissed because the music companies could not actually prove that the student was the one doing it at somebody else's computer. So it did matter. There were defenses. But copyright is not a constitutional right. It is a statutory right. In the federal courts, we uphold statutes as well as constitutional rights. And when we talk about intellectual property, a copyright is a right that is analogous to a patent right. When someone develops an invention and they get authority and permission from the United States government, the patent office, and license this is to them, then others should not violate that patent and copy it and try to make money from it. So that's what I mean by intellectual property, which is an entirely different dialogue and a different kind of case. It's very exciting.